Hi there, welcome back. This tutorial is actually the continuation of the previous lecture about inputting the data from the user. If you haven't watched the previous tutorial, I would recommend that you watch that one first. The link of the tutorial is on the screen. In addition to that, there is an entire playlist of all the tutorials in this series. I would recommend that you basically watch all of them. Anyway, let's continue. So we were basically learning how to input the information from the user and then process it. So what we did here was we declared three variables, x, y, and z, all of them integer type, and we printed this message out to make it more user friendly, so that before we expect the user to enter, we tell the user that okay, that's what you have to do. You have to enter the value of x. So we display this message. This message gets printed as is. And notice that there is no format specifier here, no percent sign or anything. So that's why basically it's going to be printed as is. And there is no variable here because, we are not trying to print any value of any variable. If we were, we would have specified the format specifier here to basically tell the compiler where to basically output the value of that message, of that variable. Anyway, then basically here, after that, we do a scanf, which basically allows us to input the value, and then %d basically shows that we are expecting an integer value here. We do the same thing with the y, and then we ask to input the value of y, and then we add these two numbers and store it in z, and then we print out by substituting the format specifiers with these variables x, y, and z here, here, and here. The sum of x, whatever the user entered, and y, whatever the user entered, is, and the sum of these two, because we computed that sum right here. So this is how you basically input the integers. Now the question is, how do you input the a character, for example? So let's do that. CHRC, and then we say, okay, scanf percent C this time, because we are basically trying to input the character. So the character format specifier is percent C, and then we don't write just the variable name here, C, as we do for printf. What we do is we basically write an ampersand before it, and what it does is basically tells the compiler, it gives the address of the compiler of this variable C. So the what compiler does is basically substitutes it with the address of the variable C. So the address of variable C is basically the place in the memory where the variable C lives. So anything that's supposed to be assigned to variable C, it needs to be written to that memory location where the variable C lives. So we have to provide the address of it. So it's very important that you use percent sign, the ampersand sign here, whenever with the scanf, for all the integers and character type variables. And then what we do is we print a message here: you entered, followed by the value of whatever was entered, backslash n, which basically takes the cursor to the next line. It's always a good idea to basically put the backslash n at the end of the message, unless you want the next message to be printed on the same line. In this program, there is no next message, so it doesn't matter, but it's a good practice to basically do that. And then we put the value of the variable c. So don't confuse this c with this c. These are two different. So suppose if I change the name of this variable to d, so what I'm going to do, D, this doesn't change. It stays the same. Percent %C basically says the character format specifier. So it doesn't change. So here it doesn't change, but here it's going to change. And let's check it out what it says. Ta-da! So see what it's doing? It's basically expecting an input for the value of d. Okay, so and this time it has to be a character, anything, you know, character could be a, b, c, x, y, z, and even 1, 2, 3 also, but they are characters, they are gonna be characters here. So I write c, then press enter, and then it says you entered c. So you see, whatever we entered, it got displayed here. But the thing is that see how quiet it was in the beginning. The user won't know, doesn't even know what it is expecting. So let's print a message before we ask the user to input. You know, before we expect the user to input. Let's see, enter a character. Okay, and then we expect the user to enter a variable, a value, any character, and then we print that value out. So let's see how this looks like. It says, see how it says enter a character, and then it stops here, waits for a character. We enter a character z, and then it says you entered, and it substitutes this value with the value of substitutes this format specified with the value of d. So very simple. So you can basically input anything you want like this. Okay, now here's something really cool. The character type data variables, you could basically treat them as numbers also. Just like at the time of printing, you can basically, even at the time of inputting, you can treat them as numbers. So what's the format specified for integers? You basically do %d. Again, don't confuse this d with this d. They are two different. So let's change this to x, character x. And we print it as d. Okay, now let's see what happens. So I think the program is still running here. Okay, it says enter a character. Well, we should have changed that now. Now we should have said enter a number, but anyway, so here, no, I'll enter 20. And then it says you enter 20. See, it changed it to the number, because we said, okay, treat this value of x as number. So what's the difference between using character as integers and using something which is declared as int? The main difference is the size, the maximum number that you can store. And the thing is that with characters, it's actually just one byte, only one byte long. And if you remember my previous lecture when we were talking about binary number system, if you haven't watched that, I would recommend that you watch it. In that lecture, I told you that everything gets represented as numbers in the computer, and characters like A, B, C, D, they are also represented as numbers. And all they need is one byte of space. One byte, in that lecture I told you that it was 8 bits. And the maximum number that you can write in 8 bits is actually 255. The minimum is 0. So the maximum value of x that you can have is 255. If that's enough for you, you declare x as a character. If that's not enough for you, you declare x as integer, or that variable as integer, because that will allow you to store big numbers. An integer can basically take as big of a number as 35,000, plus and minus, both minus 35,000 and plus 35,000. And actually here I said it a little bit wrong. X can take a maximum of, total number of values that X can take is actually 256, but the range is actually minus 128 to plus 127. That's the maximum numbers that you can write. Okay, the time is up. We will continue with our lectures. I would highly recommend that you that you watch all the previous lectures as well as all the future lectures. So, thank you very much for watching this tutorial.